Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at the Google Maps app on the iPhone. So I'm still surprised a lot of people don't know that several months ago Google came out with an independent Google Maps app. So basically the history is that when the iPhone launched and for years afterwards, there was an app on there provided in a partnership between Apple and Google that had Google Maps on it. And then with the last version of iOS, when that was released, the Google Maps app was replaced by an Apple Maps app. And they're different. There's slightly different functionality and some people prefer Google Maps. And then after a few months, Google came out with a Google Maps app. So you can download this very easily by going to the App Store on your iPhone or other iOS device and looking for Google Maps and add that to your apps on your iPhone. So here I've got it on my iPhone and I've actually put it right next to the Apple Maps app. I like to use both and sometimes I like to use Google Maps, so it's right there for me. And you can see that it looks a lot like you might be used to if you use the old Google Maps app, except that the menus are in a slightly different place. For instance, some of the most useful features at the bottom right, you might not notice the little kind of button-like thing there. If I tap it, you can see it expands. And now I can quickly go into traffic. It's one of the things I like about Google Maps over Apple Maps is for me it's much clearer and easier to see where there are traffic jams. Now you could also go down here and turn on things like public transit if that's available on Google Maps in your area. You can switch to satellite view and you can turn those off as well. And to use Google Maps here, you zoom in by pinching and separating your fingers back and forth. You can also have two fingers and rotate the map as well. The button at the bottom left will zero in on your current GPS location to make that easy. Now to search for something, you just tap at the top there and then just type what you want to search for. And this is another thing where Google Maps does pretty well. So for instance, you go to, here's my local Apple store, and then you can tap on that icon there. And it's a little different than how it looked before. It comes up at the bottom of the screen with all sorts of information. You can make a call. You can see, tap that car icon there for driving directions right away. There's photo, there's websites, reviews, all sorts of things that Google provides. You could see the same kind of information if you look on the web. And then you just sort of swipe down to put the search results there at the bottom. If you want to get out of search, you hit the X at the upper right there. Now you can also tap the directions button, which looks like the little arrows right there at the top of the screen. And now you can choose a destination, you know, from your current location to somewhere else. Then you can also choose the top. You can do car, public transportation, or walking directions. Now after I choose directions there from one place to the other, it shows me the route. There's also sometimes shows you alternate routes. You can zoom in on the route there. It gives you information. You can preview, which is useful here since I'm not actually driving, to go to each thing. And I can just swipe back and forth and see each turn at the top. A few other things. You can also tap the little person icon at the upper right, and that takes you to things pertaining to your Gmail account. If you've done map searches online before, you might find some of your history there. Or you can sign in using your Gmail account, and then it'll preserve the history as you search for things here on your iPhone. And in case you're wondering, yes, you can turn your iPhone horizontally and enter horizontal mode with Google Maps. So the question is, which one is better? And the answer is, it doesn't matter. Google Maps is free, so there's no reason you shouldn't add it as an alternative to your iPhone. You may like some things on one and some things on the other. For instance, I like that Apple Maps, it hooks up with Siri, so I can use it for directions without having to actually look at my phone while driving. And I like Google Maps, I like the traffic view. It seems a little more clear and easy to get a good picture. So I hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched and go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.